Anyway, so I said the topic I wanted to address was the demolition of partial demolition of the P. Ramli temple. And I started by putting on record that the demolition of the temple was wrong. And that's when immediately the speaker stopped me and said, and started talking about, you know, I think he was referring to breach of the standing orders and things like that. I said, well, you know, I was also wondering why he was going into other matters. Then I said, look, I'm just putting on record that, and I want to go on to discuss a solution for the problem, penyelesaian masalah. But the speaker kept interrupting me, and then I asked him to stop interrupting me. I said, let me just finish my point. The speaker seemed to be concerned that I was repeating matters which had been raised before by YB Parangsrai, and that he said these matters have been answered. And then he also seemed saying, I know about these matters because I was involved in the administration of either KL or DBKL, I'm not too clear. Yeah? So that's when I said, Speaker, you should stay out of the discussion. You're the speaker. Allow me to raise my issue and let the minister answer. And he kept going on again about breach of standing orders. I said, I did not raise any breach of standing orders. I just want to get on with my point. And I was about, then I started explaining what the point was, which is the temple is on state land. The boundary between Hapsing's land and the temple land has always been clear. I started talking about how there was a small trespass by the temple, sorted out amicably between the two parties in 2012. And I was just then I started raising about the development order of DBKL 2010, which caused the problem because it required building of structures on the temple land. So I was asking the question, why did DBKL approve and insist on such a development order, knowing that you are going to have to build things on the temple land which involve breaking the temple or trespassing the temple, and you know the temple is there? So that's a question. Itulah soalan yang saya bangkitkan. Then speaker sekali lagi mencela dan menghalang saya. Di mana saya sudah tanya, I asked him, then why are you interrupting me and stopping me, and can you stay out of the discussion? Lepas tu dia berhentikan apa ni hak saya untuk terus bercakap dan minta menteri menjawab. Di mana saya bangkit dan saya kata, saya tak terima itu, saya kena habiskan apa yang saya nak cakap. I want to finish what I want to say. And di mana dia terus bagi arahan untuk keluar daripada Dewan. So itulah apa, secara fakta lah, secara fakta apa yang berlaku. Komen saya ringkas saja. Bagi saya berhak sebagai ahli parlimen untuk bangkitkan isu ini. Malangnya saya dihalang oleh speaker sendiri. Malangnya saya nampak speaker ini macam tidak bertindak secara neutral dalam perbahasan lah. Walaupun dia mungkin tahu sedikit maklumat, itu bukan bermaksud dia tak boleh mencelah dan ambil macam memihak kepada mana-mana pihak atas isu ini. Dia patut biarkan saya cakap. Kalau saya ambil terlalu panjang masa, dia boleh halang, itu lain cerita. Tapi biar saya 5-10 minit untuk habiskan poin saya dan lepas tu menteri boleh jawab. Tapi malangnya itu telah berlaku dan speaker sudah halang hak saya untuk bersuara. Dan apabila saya bantah itu, dia terus gunakan kuasa dia untuk gantung saya. Bagi saya itu satu tindakan yang tidak wajar, tidak patut yang dibuat oleh speaker. Dan seorang speaker patut menunjukkan dia apa ni, bebas dan fair. Dia boleh lakukan yang adil kepada pembahas ahli parlimen.